am Ruchi Yadav, a second year MBA student from IIM Rotterdam. Today, we'll be interacting with one of the senior faculties of Bfactory. Bfactory is India's first edtech institute, which was started by two IIM Ahmedabad alumni. Today, we'll have this discussion over DILR, which is a section of Common Admission Test. Sir, please tell us how to attempt 4 plus DILR sets in the CAT exam.
This question I'm going to address in two parts. The first part will be like that, what will be your preparation strategy, so that how you're going to prepare so that you're going to attempt more than 4 plus certs in exams. And the second part of my answer will be like, what will be your exam taking strategy, because it depends upon both, that how you're preparing and how you're going to attempt in the exams. Okay, before going to the preparation strategy, let's analyze the paper of last 2 to 3 years of DILR. Now, the things and the trends which are common in last 2 to 3 years are, the first thing is that the paper is of moderately difficult level. That means that you won't be able to find any easy sets, and it's like 2 to 3 sets will be of a moderate difficulty level, 2 to 3 sets will be of moderate level, and 2 sets will be of difficult level. So it depends upon 2 to 3 things that how you are going to attempt the paper. We will be analyzing it one by one. So the first thing is that nowadays structured logical reasoning and DI is not common. Now, when I mean structured, it means that question based on pie charts, graph, tabular DI, or in logical reasoning, in arrangements, ordering and sequencing, team formation, selection and grouping, blood relation. So questions won't be coming from these topics nowadays, are not coming from these topics, right? So the most of the questions which are coming in exams are from unstructured. Now, unstructured means that the question will be in the form of a case slate, or you can say that in the form of a puzzle. Some topics, I'll say that in data interpretation, the most of the questions will be asked from Venn diagrams, then connecting tables where two different variables are represented in the form of a table. You need to connect to answer the questions. The question could be in the form of a missing DI, whether you need to first of all fill the missing table and you need to answer the question. The question could be based on aggregate data given, you need to connect the data to answer the questions. And in logical reasoning, this could be like, the question could be in the form of a puzzle, the question could be in the form of a case slates, this could be form of this could be in the form of a numeric logic where you need to apply the logic of numbers to solve the question. Now, these are the latest trends which are being common in CAT nowadays. So what I'll suggest that 1/3 of your preparation time should be given to structured LR, because we don't know the trend that when it's going to change. So we need to practice that also. And 2/3 of your focus should be on unstructured part. Now, there will be many difficulties when you're attempting the paper or attempting the mocks. It will be like, you won't be able, this would be possible that you won't be able to solve unstructured DI questions or LR questions very fast. That could take a lot of time in the initial phase, but believe me, eventually the time will decrease and you will be able to solve those questions within 15 minutes of time at the end. Okay. And first thing, one more thing is like, while attending the paper, while attending the sets, you need to mark down the pattern, that what are the types of questions you are solving. The second part is like that, how you are going to attempt the paper in exam. So it will be like, first of all, while giving mock, what I will suggest that go to the print mode and analyze all the edge sets possible. Now, based on those edge sets, you need to select 4. Now, that selection will be based on the types of question which you have solved earlier, or you can say that the question which contains a less number of variables which you can handle. Now, after analyzing all the sets, select 4 sets wisely, and while attempting a set, what you can do is go through the set for 2 to 3 minutes and try to comprehend that whether that given data you can be able to structure or not. If you are able to structure and comprehend the data and you are getting the language, you can go on for that set and you can solve that set possibly. In this way, you will be able to solve 4 plus tests in DILR. Okay, thank you.
Okay, I think we have found the perfect recipe to solve 4 plus sets of DILR. Select your sets, then or while preparing for the sets, give 2/3 of your time to unstructured sets and 1/3 of your time to structured sets. For more information, please log on to bfactory.in. Thank you.